This is my camera comparison of the new GoPro Hero 9 Black versus the Hero 8 versus the Hero 7. Three generations of GoPro is the latest, truly the greatest, or should you save your money? Now, I'm Ben from AuthenTech, and in this video, we're gonna find out. And a spoiler alert, the Hero 9 is not always the best. Starting with 4K 30 on each, with Super View on the 8 and the 9, which we can see how much wider field of view that gets us. This is one of the key things you get when upgrading year over year. I'd say it's mostly incremental improvements with image quality, but a lot more recipes of video settings and a few new shooting modes, like hindsight and scheduled capture. So one thing I noticed off the bat, that new HyperSmooth 3.0 is really smooth, like buttery smooth. The other two aren't bad by any means, but each year it just gets better and better, and we can clearly see the improvements made with each model. On the flip side, I'd say the 4K quality looks very similar across the board, and GoPro is still keeping up with that aggressive, contrasty look. I sort of wish its HDR and video was better improved. These three look really similar in terms of colors and white balance, and funny enough, the Hero 7 might have the best skin tones, a bit less orangey than the others, which I like. And this is audio on the new GoPro Hero 9 Black. This is audio on the GoPro Hero 8 Black. And this is audio on the GoPro Hero 7 Black. This is an audio test 1, 2, 3, 4. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram for all my behind the scenes and check out my other GoPro comparisons and my brutally honest review after this one in case you missed it. Okay, this is pretty sweet because even though they sound similar, I'd vote the 9 the best. It has the best background, wind reduction while keeping loud and clear sounding vocals. Now jumping to one of the new key features on the Hero 9. It can record up to 5K 30 and here's how that compares to 4K 30 on the other two cameras. It's a very subtle difference, and I bet if you're watching this video on a smaller phone screen, you might not even see the difference. But blow this video up on a 4K TV screen, and you should be able to spot the cleaner and more refined details on the Hero 9. You can almost spot the artificial sharpening on the Hero 7 and 8, and again, they don't look bad at all, but this 5K is a nice incremental improvement to have. Now, I wish we had 4K 120, but that's another story. Now, this is 2.7K across the board, 30 FPS, but with the new Hero 9, we can do max video. Now, this is without the mod, but we can still get that awesome horizon lock or horizon leveling feature. So for the 9, that horizon should stay pretty level, flat, vertical stay vertical. And then the other two, well, they're trying their best at stabilization, but they can only crop in and do so much. And Hero 9 should be the clear winner here.
I feel like I keep coming back here, but that's probably because I personally think it's the best feature that the Hero 9 offers. Its new Horizon Lock and Max Video Mode, same with 4K Linear plus Horizon Level on the Hero 9. I showed you guys lots of examples in my last two videos. Be sure you stick around for my upcoming review of that lens mod once I finally get my hands on it. Now, I was really surprised that this mode did not give us the best stabilization as the other two. They're actually looking a lot smoother, but I gotta remember this is without the mod, so it might look better with that, and this mode gives us the creative freedom to fully flip and rotate the camera upside down and still produce a level horizon. It's something I've been looking forward to years. Now, mark my words, I think it's only time until we see this in our smartphones. In a quick slow-mo test, all three here recording at 1080, 240 FPS, and I had really hoped for 480 this time around, but sadly, we did not get it. Let's note a very interesting observation. While the Hero 9 can enable boost stabilization in this resolution, and it's clearly giving us the smoothest horizon, its footage, however, possibly looks the worst between all three. The grass and other fine details just look mushier and softer on the Hero 9, while the 8 and the 7 look sharper. Now, isn't that just crazy? You guys gotta let me know down in the comments, would you rather have better quality or better stabilization? In hyperlapse, I set the Hero 9 and 8 in auto speed, and the 7 doesn't offer this option, so I set it to 10x. Kind of funny and odd, the Hero 8 was late to speed up the footage, and the Hero 9 is already halfway around the lake. They each look smooth in their own way. Hero 7's quality is still pretty good in my opinion. Hero 9 finished extremely fast. In low light video, all 3 and 4K, I kind of thought that the Hero 8 looked the sharpest in the fabric on the sofa chair. While panning into the super dark, I was very surprised that the 8 looked the brightest. And as for noise reduction, the Hero 9 might be the worst, which might kind of make sense, I guess, due to the more megapixels equaling smaller pixels, worse in low light. Oh, and if you guys are finding this video helpful, make sure you give me a thumbs up. That'd be so greatly appreciated. Jumping into photos, I made sure auto HDR and super photo were enabled. I was honestly surprised with some of these results. I had to go back and double check the files and make sure I had these lined up correctly. Now, even though the Hero 9 snaps larger 20 megapixel images, I was pretty disappointed when zooming into Pixel Peep. The difference between the others wasn't all that impressive. I think I can see a fair jump from 7 to 8, but a much less disparity between 8 and 9, and that's kind of unfortunate. In some of these, you could even argue that 8 is coming out sharper looking. What do you guys think? And another very big surprise, I think the 7 and 8 sometimes produce a better HDR looking shot. Like in this photo of the willow, the 9 is blowing out the highlights, and the 8 and the 7 look better in the skies. Overall, GoPro too often crushes those blacks. It's too far in my opinion, and these would look so much better with some better tone mapping. At the end of the day, I don't recommend anyone to get a GoPro for photography. It's just a wide angle lens and a tiny sensor, and you might be better off with an ultra wide smartphone shot. These are much better tuned for capturing video. So honestly, while none of these blow me away, on the same token, none of them are horrible and each produce fine looking results. Heading inside for some low light shots as the lights dim down, I think Hero 9 does the best job with noise reduction while keeping a nice clean and bright looking night shot. Even its white balance is pretty solid throughout. When the lights go almost pitch dark, I was again impressed with how the Hero 7 turned out. Now it's clearly not as good as the others, but hanging on closely behind. For such tiny sensors, the software is getting better and better with smarter exposure and processing. A few final notes, I like the larger screen and buttons on the Hero 9. However, its touchscreen is honestly much worse than the other two. I record a slow motion of this and you can count the frames, and it takes about double the time for the Hero 9 to respond. And about half the time, the UI won't even respond to my touches. It's pretty embarrassing for a brand new $450 camera. In a world of touchscreens everywhere that are super responsive, I'm not sure why this is. It's just my personal hypothesis, but if inside the Hero 9 is the same old GP1 chip from 3 years ago, it's kind of like the brain of the whole system. It might just be too slow and sluggish for that higher megapixel sensor, maybe. Anyway, hope this video was fun and helpful, and I'll see you guys in the next one.